Hello friends, in this session I will be talking about why .NET and what is .NET. This is a very interesting and basic question which people need to understand about Microsoft .NET framework. First of all, we will understand why .NET framework. Microsoft spent huge amount of time in researching on producing Microsoft .NET framework. They started it right from 1996 until Microsoft .NET framework became public and it evolved. Before I get into more details about Microsoft .NET framework, let me help you understand why .NET framework is really needed. What purpose it is really solving in industry. If you know about C or C++ programming languages, or even very basic fundamental about these two programming languages, C uses hash include stdio.h to perform printf and scanf functionality. Similarly, C++ is a similar type of programming language with object-oriented flavor in it, and it uses conio.h. These two languages are almost same. They perform same type of functionality, but they have two different type of runtime environment. They have two different set of libraries altogether, two different runtimes, two different memory management techniques, and so on. Means, if you have a specific type of application to be developed, it can be developed using C, or it can be developed using C++, but at the given point of time, you are dealing with or interacting with two different runtime environment and two different code editor windows. So this is what I was just explaining, that you have two different programming languages which require two different code editors, libraries, and runtime. So this is something which is really tedious to go with programming languages. Now assume you happen to have Visual Basic installed in your computer system, and you have a third runtime environment and a third code editor window, and it goes on and on and on the more number of languages you pile up in your computer system. Now, wouldn't it be great if you just happen to have only one set of runtime, one set of library, and one single editor to deal with programming languages? How Microsoft solved it? Let's have a look at that. So inception and what is .NET framework. It was July 2000 when Bill Gates appeared in a PDC, which stands for Professional Developer Conference, in Orlando, Florida, where he revealed that we have a product now and we call it Microsoft .NET framework. Microsoft .NET originally was named as NGWS, which stands for Next Generation Windows Service. But Microsoft's marketing team later on named it as .NET. The framework is not a new concept in industry. Usually frameworks are designed with a vision that they provide support for common functionalities. In industry, there are so many frameworks around which are providing infrastructure and support to build enterprise applications. Now, what Microsoft .NET framework does though, it is doing the similar thing what a normal framework does. So a .NET framework is also consisting of libraries and classes which are designed to achieve a common goal across various type of applications within Microsoft territory. Now, if you want to understand a little bit more about framework, then have a look at these points here, that a framework is a software layer which is sitting between your operating system and .NET compliant programming languages. So Microsoft .NET framework is a software layer which sits between your Visual Studio and operating system. It supports many programming languages, as a framework is supposed to do. It's supposed to provide common functionality across different type of applications. So Microsoft .NET framework is a common layer for all the Microsoft .NET programming languages like C#, VB.NET, C++.NET, and even F#. .NET provides common set of class libraries. So if you have a system namespace in Microsoft .NET Framework, then that is accessible by all the programming languages within .NET Framework. What languages .NET supports? This is a very interesting thing. Normally, people understand that only C# or VB.NET supports .NET Framework, whereas Visual Studio by default provides four programming languages: C#, VB.NET, C++.NET, and F#. These are four Microsoft-provided .NET compliant languages. By .NET compliant, I meant that the languages which can target .NET Framework and can compile and execute on .NET Framework. But there are many other programming languages which are non-Microsoft. Means Microsoft Corporation did not produce those languages, but Microsoft supported those programming languages to be converted into .NET compliant. What those languages are? If you want to know more about those programming languages, please go to the URL www..netlanguages.net. And when you go to this website, you will see an image like this. And this image shows all the supported languages which can target .NET today. What is the purpose of this thing? Assume you have an application written in COBOL, which is a legacy application, and you want to interact with a newly established system which is running on .NET Framework. So how these two systems can communicate? The COBOL code can be easily converted into COBOL.NET, and then these two programming languages or these two applications can talk to each other seamlessly. So that is the beauty what Microsoft .NET was providing or supporting. So hope you learned about what is .NET and why .NET. Thank you very much for watching the video.